If you think your ollie does not float, no matter how much you slide up your front foot, try to change the way you think about it. Your front foot slides up the board because the board presses against the front foot, not because the front foot presses against the board. When you pop the tail, the board lifts in an arc. The trajectory of this arc meets the position of the front foot. So by putting up your front foot while the board is pushing against it, you can lift the board without intentionally pushing it against the nose. Conversely, if you press your front foot against the board will fall without lifting as it will cancel out its energy to lift. In this video, we will scientifically analyze how a skateboard lifts in an ollie. You're watching Why the Trick, please subscribe. The most important thing to lift your ollie is to understand that there is a big difference between pressing the front foot against the board while holding the tail, and the role of the front foot in an actual ollie. They are almost entirely different, except you can get used to the feeling of rubbing the board with the side of your foot. Let's compare the physics phenomena between them. In an actual ollie, the board presses against the front foot while its angle increases to about 60 degrees. On the other hand, in the practice where you hold the tail, its angle stays at around 30 degrees. Since it does not exert any force to press your front foot, you must intentionally press your front foot against it. Thus, while this practice may help you get used to the feeling of rolling your front foot and rubbing it against the board, it does not replicate the physics phenomena in an actual ollie. If you don't pay attention to this difference and try to roll your ankle intentionally in an actual ollie, you may encounter problems where the board does not float. In order to understand what this means, let's see what happens to the board in an ollie chronologically. As explained in previous videos, the first step is to lift your body weight by jumping. It is a common misconception, but popping the tail does not lift your weight. When you are standing on your board, your body weight holds it down. So, no matter how much you pop the tail, the nose won't lift. Trying to pop the tail in this state is the same as trying to lift a nose when it has a weight equal to your body weight. Due to this reason, you need to jump before popping to remove the pressure that your weight exerts on your board. To get used to this feeling, try hippie jumps in the middle of your ollie practice. You don't need to jump so high, concentrate on reducing the pressure on the board. Squat down, extend your body, and lift your body weight into the air. Next, let's see the popping motion. When you pop the tail, the nose lifts in the form of an arc around the tail. This behavior of the board, combined with the upward force acting on your front foot, lifts the board. Place your back toe in the center of the tail. Use your ankle to pop, and avoid stomping on it. In this clip, I tried reproducing what happens when you stomp on the tail by popping on my heel. Although my board does bounce up, my body center of gravity stays low, which makes it impossible to bring up my front foot any higher. And of course, I can't stay in the air for so long. So make sure to pop on your toe. Next, slide up the board with your front foot when the nose comes up. As mentioned earlier, you do not move your front foot intentionally forward to press against the board. Otherwise, it only cancels out the force of the board. Instead, it is the board that pushes against your front foot. Please don't get me wrong, pushing your front foot forward is not always evil. When you do an ollie low, you have to push it forward to keep your front foot in contact with your board. As the nose doesn't have enough energy to come up, if you lift it too vertically, it will come off your board. The importance of not pushing the front foot stands out when attempting a higher ollie. If you keep your ankle relaxed, the force of the nose will roll it spontaneously, unlike in the practice where you hold the tail. Once your ankle is rolled, you'll have stable friction between the board and your front foot. And if you lift your front foot in this state, your board will follow it. In the next step, I will explain the second half of an ollie. But before that, please note the height of an ollie has a lot to do with how high you can pull up your front foot. So, bring up your front foot as high as possible. And this is the last step. Hold the nose with your front foot. Push it in the direction of the sole relative to the center of gravity. From the first person perspective, it looks as if the front foot is simply moving forward, but in fact, it's different. The most important thing here is the trajectory of the front foot. There are an infinite number of routes connecting the position of the nose upon popping and when you poke out your front foot. Imagine a mountainous trajectory where you lift your front foot high and lower it by holding it down. On the face of it, it might seem that it would be better to push your front foot diagonally upward so that the distance between the two points becomes the shortest. However, for the next reasons, this way does not effectively lift the tail. Any object in this universe always falls due to gravity after lifting. A skateboard is not an exception. The lifting force acts on the board gradually decreases while the front foot is sliding up, and the board eventually falls. You may be able to pull up the nose to some extent by pushing your front foot diagonally upward, but by the time you have pulled up the nose, your board and body will begin to fall. This means, if you keep pulling up your front foot, you won't be able to generate any force to lift the tail. The same is true when you push your front foot straight forward. By trying to reduce the pressure of your body weight, there is an upward force acts on your front foot. This force and the horizontal force are combined to create a diagonally upward force, and the same as the previous step happens. So, what should you do? In order to lift the tail, instead of pulling up the nose continuously, push it down while the board's center of gravity has a force to lift. Doing this creates a difference in the velocity of the board's center of gravity and that of the nose. Conversely, if you continue to pull up your front foot or push it down too late, you will push down the nose after the board begins to fall. If you push down the nose when the board is falling, you won't be able to create a difference in velocity between the two, making it impossible to lift the tail. So, it'd help if you lifted the nose quickly when the board has the energy to move upward, and then push it down without pause once it reaches the highest point. Preferably, you want to move your front foot in a sharp, mountainous trajectory. And that's all for this episode. I'm so tired, but I hope this video can help you learn how to ollie. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time.